wouldn't pick flowers with a bulldozer. So why are we still bottom trawling on sea mountains for fish?
The single biggest human threat to seamounts is bottom trawling.
And when you see the gear, you understand why. The trawl doors can weigh up to 500 kilograms apiece, and the mouth of the net can be up to 200 metres wide.
Every year in New Zealand oceans, we're wiping out some of the richest and most valuable underwater communities.
Sea mountains are actually underwater mountains, as the name suggests. They're basically like an oasis in an otherwise fairly featureless, like, underwater desert.
They provide the crucial habitat for lots of different animals.
Critically important and fragile deep sea communities live on sea mountains. And these guys are the foundations.
The corals and sponges are sort of like the building blocks of that ecosystem. And they're just like a magnet for life. So they have this sort of huge array of biodiversity on them.
Think of biodiversity on sea mountains like an underwater city. And coral are the foundations for all the essential services. They are the hospitals, the homes, the schools, and the supermarkets. Cheer, coral.
The other important thing about seamounts is that they actually break up the oceanic currents, and so deep nutrient-rich waters rise up around them. And this feeds all the other animals, and this is why there's so much biodiversity around and associated with seamounts.
And even for migratory species like whales and sharks, these are like the good towns on their road trips.
Kia ora, Bruce. Your shout, Kaze.
So we're calling for all of these seamounts and features to be protected, not because of what size or shape they are, but because of the life that's found on them. And that life is found between 200 and 1,000 metres, and that's a really critical zone to have these coral and sponge communities. But it's also the depth at which trawling occurs. And actually, beyond 1,000 metres is too deep for most trawling anyway.
Deep sea corals are really fragile and they grow really slowly.
Seamounts are home to these coral communities and they're termed vulnerable marine ecosystems.
The science is really clear. Bottom trawling has significant impacts. In other words, bottom trawling destroys entire deep sea communities like corals and can change entire ecosystems.
Imagine bulldozing a city and expecting life to carry on as normal. You're dreaming, mate.
But we're still authorising trawlers to go out and trawl seamounts in the South Pacific and allowing them to do it in Aotearoa's own waters.
I agree that forms of bottom trawling can cause damage to habitat and that needs to be minimised.
Yes, David. So why are we still bottom trawling seamounts in our big blue backyard?
Economics is the reason why these corporate fishing companies target seamounts. Biologically, it's because lots of different fish species, like orange ruffy that they catch, aggregate there.
Roughly around half of orange ruffy gets trawled on seamounts and features and half is caught elsewhere, so it's not even that that fishery can't continue. If we look at the bigger picture, New Zealand exports about 1.8 billion worth of seafood a year.
And deep water bottom trawled fish made up only just over 2% of all seafood exported in 2020. Is that all?
We have a couple of laws that look like they protect corals on seamounts, but actually they don't. So first of all, there's the benthic protection areas.
In 2007, the fishing industry made a deal with the government. They set aside about 30% of our EEZ being closed to bottom trawling. 30% sounds impressive, but there's a catch. Almost two-thirds of those benthic protection areas are too deep to trawl, which also means they're too deep for most of our deep sea corals to live.
Okay, so let me get this straight. Protected species aren't really in protected areas, and protected areas are too deep for bottom trawling and most protected species to live. What the heck?
Then we've got the Wildlife Act, and this is conservation legislation. And under that, many coral taxa are absolutely protected species.
That means I can't go out there and just take some home with me. But if I'm a corporate fishing company, legally fishing, I can go out there and destroy an unlimited amount of protected corals as long as I report it and dump them overboard. At what point does accidental or incidental bycatch become intentional?
And that's a loophole that's so big that they just keep trawling through it.
Whoopsie, sorry!
To the north, east and west of us in the South Pacific, no other countries are bottom trawling seamounts in the high seas. And further south, bottom trawling's banned altogether around Antarctica. The corporates that are going out and doing this have all been convicted recently of illegal trawling in closed areas. In terms of consequences though, these corporates are just getting issued new permits to go out and trawl again.
The only way to manage our fisheries sustainably is to stop bottom trawling on seamounts.
Almost 70,000 people have signed this petition, calling on the government of Aotearoa and the Minister of Oceans and Fisheries to protect seamounts and features from bottom trawling, and we can protect them under existing legislation.
Ah, sweet as, the Minister can easily fix this.
So we do have enough information right now for the government to protect seamounts and deep sea corals.
Like we protect these thriving forest ecosystems on land, we also need to protect these amazing coral and sponge communities found on our seamounts, and that means not dragging trawl nets across them.
So let's focus on raising our voices to the people who manage the rules, the Minister and the Ministry for Fisheries and Oceans. Together we have the power. All it takes is the will of good people.